back. True Power, Trumpet Fitness. Let me get a couple of snatches before we get started. I love the kettlebell snatch. It's the greatest thing for burning fat. The whole thing, great. Give you a six pack and give you double C's. Can't beat it. Give me a minute. Do 10, 5 on each hand. All right, ready to go. I'll get up close and personal today. Usually I do these from farther away because it gets up too close, it distorts the sound a little bit. I'm only doing this on my laptop. There's no big expensive cameras and microphones and all that sort of stuff. This is very much a mom and pop operation, but it's great for what we need. Anyway, the third part of the three basic things. If you've been watching the videos, number one, very, very important, relax the corners. Okay? Number two, very, very important, tongue through the teeth. I mean, I get more sound with my hand than a lot of people do with their instrument. That's where you get the compression. Now, the last one, very, very important, and once again, directly contradicts everything you've ever been taught, as little air as possible. I know. Fill up like you're drowning. Get the air through the horn. Couldn't be worse. Couldn't be dumber. I'll get back to that in a second. Absolutely wrong. But the fact of the matter is, the more air you're trying to get through the horn, the less compression you have. Now, what I'm going to do, and this is what I got up close, I'm going to take a very pedestrian amount of air, very shallow breath. I'm going to do it through the mouth. I usually breathe through the nose because it gives more compression. I'll get to that in another video, okay? I will do it through the mouth so you can hear how little air I'm taking in, okay? I will blow most of it out, and then I will play a short phrase, because I can't do the long phrase because of the air. But you'll see that I am not losing anything in tone and in power. It's not the amount of air, it's the compression of air that you get through the proper use of the tongue. Bruce Lee, nobody better in the whole world at compressing air. If you notice, before he would throw a punch, he would go, no. Knock the guy across the room with one finger. The best there ever was at compressing air, Bruce Lee. Anyway, check it out. Remember, tone and power. I'm hardly using any air, so I'm not going to be able to play a long phrase. Okay? But you get it. Okay? And remember, like everything else, those are the first notes of the day. I hardly used any air. The less air I use, the more I can compress it. There's your double C. Guys, I didn't warm up hardly any air. Now, what happens? Now, I know a lot of you are thinking that's crazy. That's crazy. And Arnold Jacobs, God bless him, who brought this to the tuba player and brought this to the forefront. And listen, before I go into this, guys, I am not knocking in any way, shape, or form the virtuosity of Arnold Jacobs. I'm not. He was a member of maybe the greatest brass section that ever lived. A monster among monsters. Thousands of students. I'm not knocking him. The one thing that he got wrong, though, and I do believe it's wrong, And the fact of the matter is, he contradicted himself, is that huge, huge amounts of air. I met many of his students, and he had them buying these medical devices where they're calibrating how many liters of air they can get in, and on the reverse side, how many liters of air they could pump out, okay? And it couldn't have been worse. It couldn't be more wrong. Again, even on a tuba, you have to compress. It's not the amount of air. And the way he contradicted himself, God bless him, he had emphysema and he only had one lung. Yet still, he was the greatest tuba player that ever lived. It's not the amount of air. It's the compression of air. And the way you compress it is with the tongue inside the teeth. And that's true with any brass instrument. Go back and listen to my trombone demo. I'm not a great trombone player. I don't claim to be. But I can play three octaves, okay, up to double C's on the trombone. Get a call. People are mad at me already. They're calling to complain. Anyway, again, Arnold Jacobs, the greatest. The greatest. I think, I really and truly believe he got it wrong about the amount of air. Compress with the tongue. All done with the tongue and very little air. Go back to my trombone stuff. And again, I'm not a great trombone player, but you notice I'm hardly using any air. I use hardly any at all. Okay? Relax the corners, tongue through the teeth, and don't overblow. Your playing will go through the roof. Contact me anytime you want. R.A. Salamone, R.A.S.A.L.A.M.O.N.E. at AOL.com. That is my email. If you want to buy my book, my ebook, it's out and it's selling like crazy over in Europe, believe it or not. www.tpwr.org. It's PayPal, $50. You have it in your hands. Well, not in your hands. You have it on your computer in a minute and a half. Okay. Any questions? Email me. Get the book. It works for all brass instruments. Enjoy. Do your kettlebells. Eat your fruits, vegetables, get ripped, get lean, and go through life as a true powerhouse. Have a great day, guys. Love you all.